Good evening. We welcome you live to the Sanctuary of Encounter Church on this wonderful Wednesday evening. Wednesday number one of 52. Wednesday number one of 52, where we're believing and anticipating God to move in a mighty way. We are anticipating for the remnant of God to arise and shine. Why? Because this is our season. Why? Because this is our hour. Why? Because we are coming in with the vengeance, knowing that God is on our side and he's going to propel us in. So even now, Father, we thank you, Father God, for the word that has gone forth, Father God, and the remnant will truly arise. For this season, for this hour, Father God, that there'll be a remnant, Father God, within your body, across the nation, across this globe, that will rise up for such a time as this to bring in the harvest that you desire to bring in. And it starts with us tonight. So we invite you to like, comment, and share, because we believe that this year God is going to use us and take our evangelism to another level, take our walk with him to another level. Why? Because we are the remnant. Why? Because we are the core. Why? Because the Father wants to use us to propel us into that in which he has for us and in which he has for the church. So we are part of the remnant in Jesus' name. Together as one team, just like our vision, to encounter the presence of God and to equip people of all backgrounds to become disciples of Jesus Christ. Laborers for his kingdom, one united loving family, having one heart with one purpose, together as one team, touching our community and reaching the world. And that is the vision of the remnant. Amen. I want you to comment. That is the vision of the remnant in Jesus' name. If you have a youth or a young adult, I invite you to have them join us tonight at 7:20 as we start our new series for this year, Vision Casting. Tonight, we cast a vision for their, they cast a vision for their life. We cast a vision for the youth ministry and what God is going to do. We're going to do it together, just like our vision, as one team, because we believe that God is going to use our youth and young adults in a tremendous way this year. So I invite you to gather together as a family and let's worship the Lord together, the remnant, as one team.
Amen. As one team. One team. So as Pastor Eddie said, gather the family. Maybe they haven't come before, but gather them, invite them. Let's believe that God is doing a new thing in this time, in this season, in this year. We are anticipating all that God has, and we're going to walk in something new.
Your love is devoted. Like a ring of solid gold, like a vow that is tested, like a covenant of old. Your love is enduring through the winter rain and beyond the horizon, with mercy for
the rocks have to cry out, but we will not let rocks do what we were created for. So right now, maybe you feel a little sluggish or you don't feel like it. Stand up, move around, let that worship flow from deep within. Let that worship come out, let it rise from the very depths of your soul, the very depths of your being. And we're gonna take our own worship and we're gonna pour it out at his feet, because he will be praised. But let that praise come from you. Let that praise come from me. Let it come from us. Oh, just take a moment and sing that song to the Lord. Oh, I praise you, Lord. Oh, I thank you. Oh, I lift you up. I lift you up. My Savior, my God, my King. There is no one like you, Lord.
Of all the praise, honor, and glory. Thank you so much for this night, Father God. Thank you for your blessings upon us, Lord. Thank you, Father God, that you continue to make ways where there seems to be no way. Thank you, my God. Thank you, my God. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Well, tonight we're going to engage in prayer. I want you to text down your prayer requests. And we know that the Father God reads them and sees them and hears your heart. But we're going to come into agreement today. Amen? We're going to come into agreement now. So let's pray. Heavenly Father, thank you so much for this wonderful night and this opportunity that we have to come to you with our prayers and supplications made known to you. Thank you, Heavenly Father. First and foremost, Lord, I thank you that I ask you for your blood to cover us, surround us, protect us, cleanse us, and forgive us, Lord. Father, forgive me this day for all things that weren't right, weren't thought right, didn't say right, whatever it is, Lord. Forgive me, I pray. Forgive each and every one of us by your precious blood. Father, we desire to come to you with a clean heart, Lord. And we thank you for your precious blood, Lord. And we thank you for your miracle of forgiveness, Father. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Father God. Lord, we just bring up our government before you. We thank you, Lord Jesus, that our government is blessed of you. Father God, from the White House to our house, Father, blessings of you rest upon each and every leader, we pray, in the name of Jesus. And we thank you for them, Father God. We thank you for their job. We thank you, Father God, for what they're doing in the mighty name of Jesus. And we thank you, Lord God, that racial injustice continues, Lord God, to just dissipate, Father. Father God, may peace surround, may peace abound in everyone's heart, Lord, in every person's heart, Father God, red, yellow, black, and white. May peace surround, Father God, in Jesus' precious name. Father God, let unity take place, Father, in the places of disregard. Let unity take place, we pray, in Jesus' mighty name. Thank you, Father God. Lord, we lift up all our first responders to you. We thank you for them. We thank you, Father God, that you continue to give them the stamina that they need to carry on, Father, to carry on, because we need them so much, Lord. We plead your blood upon them, your blood of protection and peace and safety, Lord. Thank you, Father God, that this COVID is drying and dying, and every variant, Father, in the name of Jesus. We don't care what it looks like or what it sounds like, Lord. We thank you, Father God, that this thing is drying and dying in Jesus' name. We thank you, Lord God, that your will continues to come, Father God, upon each and every person, Lord, and all those who are in sick beds, hospital beds, prison cells, Father God, whether they're in hospital beds or sick beds because of COVID or whatever the case may be. Father God, we ask for your healing touch upon each and every one, Lord. Father, from the crowns of their heads to the soles of their feet, Father, your healing touch upon them, Lord. And we thank you, Lord God, for those who are in prison cells, that, Father, even though they might be physically bound up, Lord, we ask that in their hearts and in their attitudes to you, in their lives to you, their dedication to you, that they're free, Father, because they love you and serve you, Lord. May there be such a renewal, Father, in the prison cells, we pray, in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, Father God, for all the bereaved, Lord, those who are hurting, Father God, so bad, Lord, because of the loss of a loved one. Father, we ask that you would touch their lives, touch their hearts, Lord. May your precious Holy Spirit comfort them like only the Holy Spirit knows how, we pray. In the mighty name of Jesus, thank you, my God. Thank you, Lord Jesus. And thank you, Father God, that you continue to lead and guide your precious fivefold ministry, Lord. From every apostle, every prophet, every evangelist, pastor, and teacher, Father. Every missionary on the field, every fivefold minister that's out there saying, I'm here alone, I'm in a tent, I'm living in the darkest place. Does anybody even know I'm here doing the work of the Lord? Father God, for the ones that have their families stateside and they're out in a third world country and they're in despair, Father God, we ask, Lord, that you would give them soundness of mind, Father God, and calmness of heart, Father God. Lord, we ask for angels to go forth and minister to these precious men and women's lives, Lord, who are putting their life at risk and their life on the line, Lord. Father, again, for every apostle, every prophet, every evangelist, pastor, and teacher, Lord, no matter where they are or where they're positioned, Father, we ask that you would just cover them and touch them and meet their needs, Lord. Whatever their needs would be, Father, we ask in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord God. Thank you, Father God. Lord, we ask that the body of Christ would rise up. Father, I've heard it said that the body of Christ is a sleeping giant. But Father, no more. No more, Father God. May that giant be not sleeping and slumberish no more. But may the body of Christ rise as the giant that they were called to be. They are called to be, Father, in the name of Jesus. May they be the remnant that they were called to be, Lord. May the hunger and thirst and drive and fire, Lord, just totally consume them, we ask, Father, in the name of Jesus. We ask, Father, in the name, mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, Father God, that you lead them and guide them. Father, to the truths of your word. And thank you, Father God, that they ignite to that. Father, they're turned on to your word. They're turned on, Father, by the things of you. And thank you, Lord God, that you enlighten them in ways that they never imagined possible, Father. In Jesus' name, slumber off in Jesus' name. Thank you, Father God. And Lord, I bring up the precious lost. Father God, the loss that we know, the loss that we don't know, the loss that we write down every week, the loss that we make our petition known every night before we go to bed. Father, you know those people. You know, you have each and every person, Lord God, that we've written down. You have them in your heart, and you know, Father, who they are. So, Father God, we just blanket them with your prayer. We blanket them with our prayer. We blanket them with your love to cover them, Father God, and bring them into a salvation, rededication place with you, Father, in the name of Jesus. Lord, no matter where they are, how it's happening, we ask, Lord God, that you would touch their lives. If it's on the job, or if it's at the mall, or if it's in the doctor's office, wherever it be, that you will touch them right where they're at, Father God. And they would be lost no more, but saved, Father God, for your glory and for your honor. And Father God, for I believe that you've been engaging with me, not just listening to me, but engaging with me, agreeing with me. Because you know what? We're not just here to be entertained and have our ears scratched. We're here to engage because we mean business, right? We mean business in the kingdom realm. So we agree with every prayer request that has been written down, everything that you're believing for. We agree in the name of Jesus, from the crown of your head to the soles of your feet, in Jesus' mighty name, let it be done. I may have not read it, and it doesn't matter, because I am just me, but God is God, and he's the one who hears and answers. He's the one who reads these. Thank you, Father God. Thank you, Lord Jesus. And now we want to pray for all of Encounter Church. I'm holding the directory in my hand, and we just want to believe for God's mighty touch upon each and every person's life. Single, married, it doesn't matter, divorced, wherever they're at, whoever they are. Father, we thank you, Lord Jesus, for your touch. Young, old, Father, it doesn't matter. Father, we ask for your touch upon these precious people of Encounter Church, Lord. May they have greater and greater encounters with you, we pray. Because it truly is all about you, Lord. Father, it's not us, but it's about you. And we thank you, Father God, for your touch upon them, Lord. May 2022, Father, be a year beyond, a year that they never imagined possible. In Jesus' mighty name, thank you, Lord God. And thank you, Father God, for the prophetic word that went forth. Let it be a word that continues to permeate our very being. The remnant. The remnant, that means the ones that are singled out, the ones that God's called. That's what we desire to be. Father, let your prophetic word and your favor, Father, flood each and every one of our lives in Jesus' name. And Father God, for every prayer request, these are precious prayer requests that you guys have put down on paper. God knows them. God sees them. So, Father, we thank you. We dedicate these to you. And Father God, we ask that there are prayer requests now, but Lord, in the supernatural, we believe that they're praise reports for your glory, Lord, in Jesus' mighty name. Thank you, my God. Amen. God bless you.
Oh, Lord, sing. For your name is great and greatly to be praised. I sing praises to your name. Oh Lord, praises to your name. Oh Lord, for your name is great and greatly to be praised. I give glory to your name. I give glory to your name. That's it, sing. Oh Lord, glory to your name. Oh Lord, for your name is and greatly to be praised. I give glory to your name. Oh Lord, glory to your name. Oh Lord, for your name is great and greatly to be praised. Tell him for your name. For your name is great and greatly to be praised. For your name. For your name is great and greatly to be praised. Give him a big hallelujah all over this house. Come on. Hallelujah. Let me hear you at home. Let me hear you at home. Hallelujah. Amen. We have the victory. Somebody comment, Omicron, be gone. Omicron, be gone. It has a name, it's got to go.
Yes, it does.
Has a name, it's got to go. The Bible says everything has to bow to the name of Jesus. Omicron, got to go. Omicron, gone.
Yes.
Omicron, gone. Come on, Omicron, gone. Has a name, it's got to go. The name of Jesus, every knee shall bow.
Yes.
Anything that has a name. Omicron, gone. Come on. Yes. If you don't know how to spell it, that's okay. That's okay. Be gone. Just comment, be gone. Be gone. Come on. Be gone. Come on, Pastor Derek, shout, be gone.
Be gone.
You talking to me? You talking to me?
Omicron.
Willis, you talking to me?
What you talking about?
Omicron, gone. Be gone in the name of Jesus.
Yes.
Kingdom of heaven suffers violence, and the violent take it by force. Amen. Oh, I love you so much, church. And thank you again for, I know you blessed us for Christmas. Thank you so much for blessing my family and I. Thank you so much. Thank you for praying for my family. Thank you, 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 thank you. And my Charlie's being healed of COVID. My Charlie's being healed of COVID. My Mark is being healed of COVID. My Janelle is being healed of COVID. And they are doing wonderful. We've had no contact with them, only by FaceTime. Thank God for FaceTime. Yes, thank God for Facebook Live. And they're doing well, they're doing better, they're doing well to the glory of the Lord. And we thank God for all of your recoveries, all your families, all for your daughter's healings. Yep, your two daughters. Yep, we declare them well in Jesus' name. For your two sons, your one son, your granddaughter, your mother, your father, your in-laws, your loved ones, we declare them all well. Listen to me. I don't care what you see on the news, here on the news. We have the promise, listen to me, of the eternal covenant of God's word. God's word will win. God's word will prevail. Many are the afflictions of the righteous, but God. Come on. Somebody shout at home, but God.
But God.
But God delivers us out of some of them.
No.
Most.
No.
All.
Yes.
All means all. Somebody say all means all.
All means all.
All means all. Forever you will be. Sing to the Lord. I love to sing to him. Lamb upon the throne. I gladly bow my knee. Worship you alone. Forever and ever and ever and ever. Forever you will be. Sing it to the Lord, Lamb upon the throne. Oh yes, I gladly bow my knee to worship you alone. Now we pray for our friend, Pastor Denver Thompson. in England, originally from Ireland. England, you know, I was in England a couple, 2-3 years ago, and he hosted me, and boy, did he take really good care of me. I ministered in several churches I ministered in, and it was awesome being there. It was awesome being there in those several churches, and we had a great time in the presence of the Lord. And then, of course, last year, I was supposed to go back and minister, I think, in 12 churches?
Yeah. Almost
2 weeks. I was going to be gone for 2 weeks and minister, I think, in 12 churches. But those days are coming back. Anyway, Brother Denver Thompson, he texted me earlier today, and they're in England. They're like, I think, 6 hours ahead of us. And he was rushed to the hospital, not COVID-related, but they're not sure what it is. So they're doing, you know, different exams on him, blood work on him. They're just checking him up from the crown of his head to the soles of his feet. He's just having discomfort in his body, unrelated to COVID. So we thank God for Denver Thompson's healing now in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. He sent his word and healed them. Yes, he did. And for the continuation of the healing of Pastors Bill and Gina Nuevez in Long Island, New York, they were on Facebook Live tonight. They're mighty warriors. They're troopers. Want to talk about remnant? You want to talk about remnant? Pastors Bill and Gina Nuevez, remnant people, remnant pastors, remnant churches. And I thank God for their full breathing capacity.
Yes.
In their lungs, in their chest, their vocal cords. They are blessed and they are well in Jesus' matchless mighty name. And for every single one of you, wow, look at you all, look at you all, look at you all of you well and blessed. I'm looking at this, look at you all, precious people. You know, I'm just going through this, just these comments here, and my heart melts, my heart melts. Can you imagine how the Lord must feel about you? He put your name on the roll. He put your name on the roll. You know why I love rock and roll? You know why I love rock and roll? Pastor Derek, do you know why I love rock and roll?
Why do you love rock and roll?
I love rock and roll because I serve the rock and my name is on the roll. That's why I love rock and roll. I serve the rock and my name is on the roll. And there's an old hymn we used to sing. Pastor Derek, I don't know if you know this. When the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there. When the roll is called up, you don't know it, huh? You youngster, you?
I've heard it, but I can't think of it.
All right, here it goes. Guys, this is old time. Listen to me. Listen to me. Hold on one second. One second. Oh, my. Hymn number 297. Hymn number 297. Pastor Joni, do you know that song? You don't know it, huh? All right, I'm going to get you guys tonight. I bet your Mama Boehner knows it. Give me some Hammond sound. Would you? Just give me some Hammond sound, whatever it is, Pastor Derek. Come on. We're going to do it a couple different styles tonight. Because God is glorified.
That's not Hammond.
Nah, give me some Hammond, baby. Give me some B3, would you? Come on now, do it again. Do it again, yeah. You know, folks, I'm really having church tonight. Here it goes. When the roll is called up yonder, when the roll, I feel like having church tonight. When the roll. Folks, you can't make this stuff up. This is the real thing. My soul burns within me. When the roll is called up yonder. When the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there. Come on. When the roll is called up yonder. When the roll is called up yonder, when the Zebra is called up yonder. I know I'm going to be there, and I know that you're going to be there, but we pray right now for our unsaved loved ones. We pray right now for unsaved family members. We pray for our workers, our employees, our employers, that their name will be written down in the Lamb's Book of Life. Father, we intercede right now for the lost. We intercede right, the remnant right now. Come on, church. The remnant right now. We intercede for the lost. Satan, let go. Let go of them. They're not going to hell. You may have put them through hell. You may have put them through hell, but they ain't going to hell because we're a church of intercession. We're a church of warfare. The remnant knows how to war. The remnant knows how to war. The remnant knows how to restore. And we declare our friends, our families, our children, the backsliders, to come back home. Come back home. Children, come back home. Daddy, come back home. Mama, come back home. Why? So that when the world is called up yonder, when the world is called up yonder, that means their name written down in the Lamb's Book of Life. Their name written down in the Lamb's Book of Life. When the world is called up yonder, we're going to sing, they'll be there. They'll be there. Somebody shout, they'll be there.
They'll be there.
When the roll is called up yonder, they'll be there. When the roll is called up yonder, when the roll is called up yonder, someday it will, when the roll is called up yonder, they'll be there. When the roll is called up yonder, they'll be there. Come on, you give God a shout for their victory. Give them a shout that they're coming home. I said they're coming home. I prophesy they're coming home. They're coming home. They're coming home. Patty, they're coming home. Pastor Gina, they're coming home. Your kids, your family's coming home. Lori, they're coming home. Nola, they're coming home. Glenn, they're coming home. Sherry, Nancy, they're coming home. Nydia, they're coming home. Marisol, they're coming home. Marisol, they're coming home. Sally, they're coming home. Mary, they're coming home. Audia, they're coming home. Mark, they're coming home. They're coming home. Glenn, they're coming home. They're, Cora, they're coming home. When the roll is called up yonder, when the roll is called up yonder, when the roll is called up yonder, we declare it, they'll be there. When the roll is called up yonder, they'll be there. Play it, Pastor Derek. We're having church tonight. We're having church tonight. See, in the Bible, when the prophets heard a certain sound, somebody shouted home, a certain sound.
A certain sound.
When the prophets heard a certain sound, miracles took place.
Yes.
Wonders took place.
Yes.
That's why David didn't just call for anybody. He could have had anybody. But he needed somebody. The right person. Saul did, that is. Saul needed the right person, and he called on David. Could have called on many guys, but he needed a certain sound. Certain sound will bring deliverance. Certain sound will bring healing. When they were marching around Jericho, seven times, I believe it was a certain sound that brought that wall down. Sometimes it's a, hear me, sometimes it's a certain shout that will bring that wall down. Come on, somebody. You're not here, but you're here. Come on. Sometimes it's a certain song. I'm serious. Sometimes it's a certain key. Sometimes it's the key of D, don't cut it. Sometimes it takes the key of C. Sometimes it takes the key of F. Whatever it takes, sometimes it takes a certain sound. It's the way the Holy Ghost works, especially in the prophetic. Tonight's your night. Welcome to our first Wednesday night of 52. And just like that, it'll seem like a few weeks from now, and you'll be saying, it's 52 already? And we're going to say, uh-huh. And you know what you're going to say? I'm still alive. Come on. I said, I'm still alive. Mm-hmm. What you doing back there, Pastor Derek?
Playing.
You're sounding good. Certain sound. You're sounding good. Thank you, Father. Somebody shout, thank you, Father.
Thank you, Father.
Yep. For all of you and all your family members. Uh-huh. Yep. Arlene, yep. Gotcha. Got you all covered, babies. Baby girls, got you all covered. Guys, got you all covered. Oh, Mama. Mama Boehner says, when the roll is called, you see, she knows. Mama Boehner knows. When the roll is, listen, this is all to the glory of God. This is all to the glory of God. But Mama Boehner, this is for you. When the roll is gone up yonder, when the roll is called up yonder. When the roar. You know, the Bible says, become all things to all men. Don't judge me. Bible says, become all things to all men. That's what I'm doing. When the roar is called up yonder. When the roar is called up yonder, you'll be there. Okay, Pastor Derek, let's do it Assembly of God style. Let's do it Assembly of God style. I'm sorry, you have to stop playing the Hammond now. Do you have an old-fashioned piano? When the roll is called up yonder, when the roll is called up yonder, when the road is called up yonder, when the road is called up yonder, I'll be there. When the road is called up yonder, when the road is called up yonder, when the road is called up yonder, when the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there. That's Assembly of God style. Let's do it. Let's do a Hispanic style. Give me some salsa. Come on. Judy, lay hands on him, would you? Come on. Give me some salsa. Come on. When the roll is called up yonder, when the roll is called up yonder, when the roll, hallelujah, is called up yonder, when the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there. Gloria a Dios. When the roll is called up yonder, 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 I'll be there. Hallelujah. That's the Shekinah glory.
That's the Shekinah glory. Pastor Derek, give me some Hammond again. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Folks, this is real. We're really having church tonight. Give me some more Hammond. Yeah. Whoa. What a day that will be. Yeah, 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 yeah. When my Jesus I shall see. When I look upon his face. The one who saved. They said there was no hope for me. The one who saved. They said I was gonna fail. The one who saved me by his grace. And you know what? They were right. I did fail. But the greater one picked me up again. When he takes me by the hand and leads me through the promised land. I'll sing that again. What a day that will be for all of us when my Jesus I shall see. When I look upon his face, the one who saved me by his grace. When he takes me by the hand, leads me through the promised land. Oh, what a day, glorious day that will be. Oh, oh. See, sometimes you have to encourage yourself in the Lord. Come on, somebody. Sometimes you got to encourage yourself in the Lord. Somebody just tuned in. Not an accident. Not an accident. Sometimes you got to encourage yourself in the Lord. You see, my son was scheduled to be with us for Christmas, but he got COVID, or COVID tried to get a hold of him, but he overcame. So he changed his flight, and he was supposed to be with us tonight. He changed his flight to be with us tonight. But then little Charlie got COVID, tried to get a hold of him, but he's recovering. So now we're going to see my son sometime in February. We still haven't celebrated Christmas yet. Our Christmas tree is still up. The gifts are still under the tree. And I thought tonight my son would be here, but Father knows best. Do I look discouraged to you? Am I angry? Did it upset me? Sure it did. I'm just human. But then I tap in. You know why? Because it's amazing what praising will do. Somebody's getting set free right now. I'm preaching by singing. I'm preaching by demonstrating. It's amazing what praising will do. So no matter what you go through, when he takes me by the hand, and you know what? He's got you by the hand right now. Leads me through the promised land. Oh yeah. More and more of you are tuning in because you're sensing the anointing. I don't know how that happens on Facebook, but the anointing, people are drawn to the anointing. Oh yeah. What a day. Glorious day. Smile, come on. Somebody give me a bunch of smiles. What a day. Glorious day that will be. You are so beautiful to me. Can't you see? You're everything I hope for. Everything I needed. You are so beautiful.
to me. The Lord says to you, you are so beautiful. You are, yeah, so beautiful to him. Yes, you are. You may not think you are, but you are. You are so beautiful to him. Yes, you are. You're made in his image. I don't care what that guy said about you. It's his loss. But I pray he gets found. You are so beautiful to him. Can't you see? You're everything he's wanted. That's why he died on the cross. And he's everything we need. That's why he is so beautiful to us. Folks, what an opportunity during this time of crisis in America. What a golden opportunity for the church to arise and give the world hope. Folks, this is our window like never before, because we're witnessing what we've never witnessed before in the world. So why not witness everything great in the church? Don't get quiet on me. But what a window of opportunity we have right now to be an encouragement to our neighbors, literally, the people right next door, literally, people we work with. This is the church's window. Hear me. This is the church's window of opportunity to give hope to the world. This is our opportunity. This is our window. May we be used, Lord, to do the work of an evangelist. We're all evangelists in the eyes of God. May we be used as carriers of hope. Carriers of soteria, salvation. Carriers of joy. We're getting something tonight. I'm serious, folks. God's given you a window tonight. Tomorrow, when you wake up, there's a window waiting. Somebody comment, there's a window waiting. Has somebody's name on it to put their roll, their name on that roll, so that when that roll is called up yonder, you can say it was somebody I led to the Lord. When that roll is called up yonder, you'll be able to say, because I interceded for them. When that roll is called up yonder, when that roll is called up yonder, they'll be there. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory to God. And somewhere in between the black and the white, Hispanic, the Asian was in the mix as well. The Asian, you were in between the African American, you were in between the African American and the Spanish. We put you right in the middle. Chinese, Japanese, we got you covered too. We got you all covered. Most of all, he's got you covered with the blood. Oh, the blood. Jesus. Sing with me. Oh, the blood of Jesus. Sing with me, church. Oh, the blood of Jesus, it washes white as snow. Come on, let me hear you sing. Oh, the blood of Jesus. Oh, the blood of Jesus. Talking about the blood. It washes white as snow. You know, I was thinking, it's one of the things I do, I think. I was thinking how as I said on Sunday, how Hitler, in the early 40s, murdered over six folks, over 6 million Jews. Think about that for a minute. Gas chambers. Over 6 million of God's chosen people. And World War II was going on. The Depression was coming to an end. What a time that must have been for the church then. But the church survived. I said the church survived. The remnant survived. I'm not making light of what we're going through in America today. I'm not making light at all. But when you put things in perspective, Christians, brothers and sisters in the Lord, during the Roman Empire, Christians like me, were thrown into the Colosseum. And they loosed lions and tigers upon them to devour them, to eat their flesh alive. Christians by the thousands. But we've survived. Nothing will ever stop God's church. No pandemic. No fear, no worry. Why? Because He lives. You can face. I'm prophesying. Somebody got out of bed this morning discouraged. It's not going to happen tomorrow. I said it ain't going to happen tomorrow. Because He lives. You can face tomorrow, yes. Because He lives. This is for all of you now. This is for all of you. All fear is gone. Because I know He holds the future, and life is worth the living just because He lives. Come on, declare it over your life, over your family. Because He lives, I can face tomorrow.
Because He lives.
Prophesy this part. Prophesy this part. Pastor Derek, tell him.
All fear is gone.
All fear is gone.
Because I
know who holds my future. Oh, yeah. And life is worth the living just because He lives. And life is worth the living just. I'm going to say it again because I'm going to prophesy it again. I'm going to prophesy it right to you. And life is worth the living just because He lives. Come on, guys, give Him a shout of praise.
Hallelujah.
Come on, give Him a shout of praise. Shout of praise.
Hallelujah.
It's amazing what praising will do. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. It's amazing what praising will do. Hallelujah. Now watch this, folks. Watch this. Watch this. This is all live. This ain't Memorex. You remember the 70s and 80s? Memorex? This ain't Memorex. Pastor Derek, you just play any sound and I'm going to sing to it. Play any. There you go. You just play any sound. Watch this. This is the Holy Ghost. This is the Holy Ghost. It's amazing what praising will do. Yes, it's amazing. Oh, amazing. Yes, it is. Yes, it is. I said, yes, it is. I said, yes, it is. It's amazing what praising will do. Yeah. It's amazing what praising will do. Yeah, 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 yeah. It's amazing what praising will do. It's amazing what praising will do. Imagine what the heavens are going to sound like. Heaven's not going to sound white. Heaven's not going to sound black. Heaven's going to sound like heaven. Amen. Which means you're going to hear a black, white, Hispanic, Asian, Filipino, Oriental sound as one. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Kriti la tadabusa. You're being encouraged tonight, aren't you? It's only the first of 52. Somebody comment, the first of 52. We got 51 more to go, baby. We got 51 more to go, baby. No sickness, no flu, no germ. No disease gonna get me down. Anything that tries to come near my babies, my God's got this. My God's got this. Yes, he does. Yes, he does. Always has, always will. Look at the Jews today. They're blessed, aren't they? Yet Adolf Hitler assassinated over 6 million. But God found a way where there was no way to restore Israel. God's going to restore America. I'll say it again. God's going to restore America. He's going to restore the church.
Yes.
The church. The remnant. Somebody shout the remnant.
Remnant.
Shout it.
Remnant.
Let me hear you in Bartlett.
Remnant.
Let me hear you in Elgin.
The remnant.
Let me hear you in Rockford.
The remnant.
Salute. I got a great verse to share with you. They're all great verses, I'm telling you. But Daniel chapter 12, verse 3. Listen to this. Daniel chapter 12, verse 3. Listen to this very carefully. We're having church tonight. This is one of 52. Got 51 more to go after this. And if we don't make it to 52, you know what that means? You know what that means if we don't make it to 52?
We'll celebrate in heaven.
We'll celebrate in heaven. Because no virus has taken you out, no virus has taken me out.
Amen.
No bullet's going to take you out, no bullet's going to take me out.
Amen.
No car wreck's going to take you out, no plane crash going to take me out.
Amen.
Hey, hear me. I prophesy. This is not arrogance, this is confidence. I prophesy. I'm going out in style.
Yes.
You're going out in style.
Yes.
Devil, enough is enough. But listen to Daniel. I love that name, Daniel. Some people have the name Daniel and they call themselves Dan. Dan is nice. Joe is nice. But I like Joey. I like Joseph. Dan, you're the man. Dan's okay. But I like Danny. You know, it just makes it just more, just makes it a little more intimate, you know? You know, my friends call me Jimmy. My friends call me Jimmy. Just makes it just a little more intimate, you know what I'm saying? But Daniel, man, when I hear the name Daniel, I hear a prophet. I hear a prophet. Whether Dan, Danny, Daniel, you're all good, you're all good. But Daniel! Chapter 12. 12 is apostolic. Verse number 3. That's the Trinity. Look at this. Now this is for you, church. Say, this is for me. Come on, say, this is for me.
This is for me.
Let me hear you. This is for me.
This is for me.
Let me hear you at home. This is for me.
This is for me.
For the people who are wise. Say, that's me.
That's me.
For the people who are wise, listen to this, shall shine like the brightness of the heavens. On our way to church tonight, we looked at that moon. Oh, man, was that thing sharp. Like a, what do you call it, babe? A nail?
It looks like a fingernail.
For those, for the church, the remnant, who walk in wisdom, you're going to shine. And during the stormy season, you're going to shine even brighter. You're going to shine even brighter, not darker, brighter.
Yes.
The world gets darker, which means you get brighter.
Yes.
We also get brighter up here and having the mind of Christ. And you'll shine like the brightness of the heavens. And those who turn to righteousness, you're going to be like the stars forever and ever. You're going to be like the stars forever and ever. My. What a night this has been. What a night this has been. So folks, God's given us a window now to shine our light. He's given us a window. He always has, but especially now, the world needs us. I said the world needs us. This ain't the time to argue politics. The world needs us.
Yes.
Yes.
Well, I'm going to say it. This ain't the time to get Trump back in office. It's time to get Jesus back in office.
Yes.
I'll say this too. It's not a Bidenite. It's not a Bidenite that can get it done. But Jesus. There's not a Trumpite. There's not a Sodomite. There's not a Bidenite. There's not a De Palmaite that can make it right. But he's going to make it all right. I said he's going to make it all right. He's going to make it all right. He's going to make it all right. He's gonna make it all right. He's gonna make it all right. Come on, come on. He's gonna make it all right. He's gonna make it all right. He's gonna make it. He's gonna make it. He's gonna make it all right. Come on, sing. He's gonna make it all right. He's gonna make it all right. He's gonna make it. He's gonna make it. He's gonna make it all right. Now listen, stop commenting for a minute. Stop commenting. I don't want you to lose this. Put your hands together. He's gonna make it all right. He's gonna make it all right. He's gonna make it. He's gonna make it. He's gonna make it all right. Come on, do it again. He's gonna make it all right. He's gonna make it all right. He's gonna make it. He's gonna make it. He's gonna make it all right. I said, he's gonna make it all right. I said, he's gonna make it all right. Like the old preacher in the South said, I preached myself happy. I preached myself happy. I don't care what it sounds like to somebody else, but to me it feels good. but to me it feels good. Never wanted to be on Star Search anyway. Never wanted to be on America's Got Talent anyway. Just give me Jesus. And let me tell you, on America's Got Talent, some of these shows, I'm telling you why, I don't know, I don't watch them much, but the gospel's really getting out through some of these singers, and yeah, thank the Lord. Well, so guys, real quickly, just 5 minutes, 5 minutes, 5 minutes. What's God showing you through this message on New Year's Eve for the year? What's God showing you? Give me a few comments. God's doing something mighty, huh, Pastor Derek?
He is. He is.
If you want to sit down, sit down. Go ahead.
I'm good.
You're good.
Unless you want me on.
He's good. Yeah. God is good. Come on, comment. Comment. Joe, if he's hearing you, let me know. Amy, let me know. Judy, talk to me. If you see comment, because I'm singing right now. Come on. What God show you for the New Year's message? What God show you for the New Year's message? What God show you? Come on. What God show you? Uh-huh. What God show you? Come on, let me see. Who's the first? What God show you? Yeah, they're coming home. They're coming home. They're coming home. They're coming home. Uh-huh. Yep. Yep. Oh, look at these comments. Well, I'm way behind you guys. Mm-hmm. Thank you, Lord God. Thank you, Jesus. What's God showing us for the new year, church? What did God speak to us New Year's Eve? What did God speak to us on the first Sunday? Hey, Marina, keep smiling, baby. Keep smiling, baby. You are the light of the world, baby. Jesus is the ultimate light, but we are the light of the world in Jesus for the world. We're the light for the world. Oh, look at all these smiles. Well, I'm way behind here, guys. See, I started singing. Look at this. Who's saying what? Okay, somebody said discernment is the key. That's what you got for 2022? Good. A few more. Come on, guys. The remnant? Good. There you go. Come on. Double portion? Good. What did God show you through me speaking the word of the Lord on New Year's Eve, New Year's? The remnant will arise in 2022 despite whatever's going on in the world. Yes. Yeah, somebody else. Come on. Come on, guys. Would you learn? I preached, I prophesied. Let me hear from you now. Come on. Yep. Yep. The remnant will thrive and survive. We've got work to do. Yes. Yeah, yeah. Double for the remnant. Yeah. No weapon formed against us shall prosper. Come on, a few more, guys. Yeah. Don't get quiet on me now. Don't get quiet on me now. I sowed seed. Let me see some harvest now. Let me hear some testimony. God is showing me everything's going to be all right in 2022. We're going to rise above in everything. Amen. Another, no weapon formed against me. Yep. Compassion for one another. There we go. Now we're getting hot. Now we're getting hot. There we go. There we go. The remnant is the core, and the core is where the seed is. Oh, come on. Somebody's taking notes here. Uh-huh. The fear of the Lord, yes. What God has showed us that no one can, you guys are going so quick now, that no one can what? Interfere with us, interfere with in Jesus' name. Amen. No one can interfere. Sound godly application, what the remnant will use. All right, what else, guys? Did I miss any, guys?
No.
Did I miss any? All right. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Well, we'll get more of this on Sunday, all right? No other name but the name of Jesus. No other name. Yeah, please God in everything. I see that. Forgive no matter what. There you go. Forgive no matter what. Keep singing. The fear of the Lord, the glory of the Lord is rising upon us. There you go. Sing, come on.
Glory and worthy of honor and worthy.
the name of Jesus.
No other name but the name of the Lord. No other name but the name of Jesus is worthy of glory and worthy of honor.
Close now. I'm going to close. Stretch your hands toward me. Stretch your hands toward me. Father, you've given us a night of nights tonight. Thank you, Lord, for the variety of the Spirit. Thank you, Lord, for the variety of the Spirit. Father, now this night is sealed for eternity. Tonight we've praised you. We've worshiped you. Tonight, Lord, we received encouragement for the new year. Lord, we are the remnant. We're not the crowd. We're more than just commenters. We're more than just committed. We're the core, Lord. We're the core, Lord. We're the remnant. We choose to be, Lord. Some say they are, but we choose to be. We choose to live like it, act like it, to be it, Lord. You've given us a window now, Lord, to reach the world for such a time as this. If the world ever needed us, they need us now. May we be ministers of reconciliation to the body of Christ, to our families, and to a lost and dying world. In Jesus' name. Sealed now in your spirit, people. It's sealed in your mind and body. Now remember, you're going to wake up tomorrow. The core. You're going to wake up tomorrow. You're not going to be depressed. You're going to take this anointing and carry it over. You go to bed tonight. You don't need to see what the crime rate is. You don't need to see the spikes of COVID. You need to just keep your eyes upon Jesus. Look full in his wonderful face. And the things of earth, and the things of earth will grow strangely dim in the light of his glory and grace. So you take this anointing, church. You take this and you protect it now. You protect it now. Hebrews chapter 12, verse 2. Hebrews chapter 12, verse 2. Looking unto Jesus. Looking unto Jesus, the author and finisher of your faith. Listen to me. He began it, he'll finish it. He started it, he'll end it. That's the good work. The good work. The good work. The good work. He who began it. Remember that verse. What did I just say? Hebrews 12, 2?
Yep.
Yes.
Looking unto Jesus. Keep your eyes upon Jesus. Look full in his wonderful face. And the things of earth will grow strangely dim in the light of his glory and grace. The song really starts with,
Turn your eyes.
Turn your eyes upon Jesus. But we sang,
Keep
your eyes. We've already turned our eyes on him.
Yeah.
Let's keep our eyes on him.
Right.
See, I'm telling you, folks, everything I'm doing tonight is coming from the Lord, my spirit. Preparation of a heart belongs to a man, but the answer of the lip is of the Lord. Keep your eyes upon Jesus. Folks, look at this. This is no joke. This is all stuff I have to share with you. I was going to share with you tonight a lot of this stuff here. Look at this. Look at this, folks. Look at this. There's a purpose for this. There's a purpose. Look. Now, I wasn't going to share this all, not all, but I didn't get to share any of it. I didn't get to share any of it. Why? Why? I did my preparation. I did my preparation. I did my preparation. But the Holy Ghost had his way tonight in exactly what we needed, what you needed. Man, I was going to talk more about where we left off on New Year's Eve and this past Sunday. But when the Holy Ghost has his way, look out.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. I'm leaving tonight joyful. And you know what? I'm leaving happy. I'm leaving happy.
You know what?
Remember Droopy?
You know what? I'm happy. You know what? I'm happy.
I'm happy in Jesus. Trust and obey. For there's no other way to be happy in Jesus is to trust and obey. Trust and obey. For there's no other way to be happy in Jesus. What are you looking at me like that? Why are you looking at me like that? They can't hear you. Why are you looking at me like that? Why are you looking at me like that? You know why? Because we're happy in Jesus. And to trust and obey. Love you all so much. It's been a fun night, a good night, a godly night. Now let's... We're joyful now, right? We're joyful? I said we're joyful. I said we're joyful. First of all, Encounter Church, I want to thank you for your faithfulness to God in the year 2021. I want to thank you to your faithfulness to God's work. I want to thank you for teamwork makes the dream work. Thank you for your faithfulness and your tithes and offerings, first fruits, oblations. And now I pray that God gives you more in 2022. I pray that God gives you more in 2022. I pray that more comes into the house. I pray that more comes into the house, to the church. And I pray more comes into your house. Not just money, yeah, money. Honey, but more peace.
Yes.
More joy.
Hallelujah.
Tonight you won't see this on Channel 2, Channel 5, Channel 7, Fox or CNN. But this is the good news. The gospel is the good news. So tonight the Lord loves a cheerful giver. The joy of the Lord is my strength. The joy of the Lord is my strength. The joy of the Lord is my strength. Let's do this, Pastor Derek. You just play any sound you in the world that you can ever think of. You play any sound. Whether you've ever played it before and never played it. Play any sound. Doesn't have to be that sound. Play any sound. Now watch and see what the Lord's going to do. Come on. He's laughing. They don't do it that way in Minnesota. But thank God for God calling him here. He's doing it the right way. They don't do it this way in New York. We're doing it God's way. The joy of the Lord is my strength. 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 Ha 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 ha. The devil said what? Ha 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 ha. Now the Lord loves a cheerful giver. So tonight, let's give us to the Lord. I know you're not in the building, so now you can drive to the building. You can come tonight. You say, it's too cold, it's too windy. Baby, you got the Holy Ghost. You can come in the morning before you go to work. Okay? You can put it in the mail. You go online right now. Hey, Joan Rennemacher, tell them how to do it, Joan. Tell them how to, you're a giver. Tell them how to do it, Joan. You pay your tithe, Joan. You sow your seed, Joan. Tell them how to do it, Joan. We see your checks every week, baby. You show them how to do it, Joan. Show them, Joan, how to do it. Come on, show them, Joan. Folks, you can go online right now. You can go online right now. And you can give right now. You can give right now. OurEncounter.com. Yeah. All of Encounter Church knows how to do it. Let's see who's there. Nancy, you know. You can tell them, Nancy. Yep. 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 You're broke. You know why you're broke? Give. God supplies seed to the sower. God supplies seed to the sower. Give and you won't be broke, honey. Give and you won't be broke, honey. Ha ha ha. The joy of the Lord is our strength. Love you all, folks. Sunday, fire. Sunday, fire. Tremendous Thursday. Fabulous Friday. Call the church. Call the church. Call the church. Let this be your best year ever. This is the year of the remnant. I love you all so much. Whether I called your name or not, love you all so much. God bless you.